A good day to you. I bring the good wishes of Moff Sarek, the officer entrusted with annexing this planet. He has been anticipating your arrival.
Either I'm moving up in the world, or there are people he wants dead.
Knowing the Moff, sir, I would guess more than a few.
Good day. You have served us before, have you not? A valuable hire. I expect you care little for the niceties of politics here, so I will be brief. The Empire intends to use Alderaan's succession struggle to bring it into the fold, and I'm offering you the opportunity to play a pivotal role.
Is this a job interview, then?
Oh, you have the job, if you're willing. We would not be speaking otherwise. The heir to Alderaan's throne was recently assassinated, right after withdrawing from the protection of the Republic. The planet's in civil war, and for the first time in thousands of years, without the armies of the Republic to bring order.
A divided world will fall quickly.
Yes. We must make our move now, while the throne stands empty. We have an alliance with one of the noble houses, House Thul. The house was exiled 60 years ago after a failed bid for power, and came to us instead. Unfortunately, they have proven too weak to do what's needed.
You got someone they're not killing for you?
Yes. But Thul must also learn what it means to be an arm of the Empire. Jorad, one of the Thul lords, insists on following Alderaan's rules of civilized warfare. I want you to show him warfare is far from civil. Several of Thul's vassal houses have rebelled since Thul's connection to us became public. This cannot be allowed. Take a slave collar from my man here and drag one of these rebels to our weak-willed Lord Thul. Kill the rest and leave them where they fall.
They will learn that the best way to survive is to submit.
These lords of Alderaan must lose their foolish pride. Those who will not bow must break.
Put my mind to it.
What is... who... Crymar? Is that Crymar Noven? That's a free nobleman of Alderaan. Unhand him. Who are you? What's this about? Oh!
Moff Sarek sent me to round up these traitors.
Yes. Moff Sarek had suggested using tactics like,
All of Alderaan will be thrown into chains because of you!
You two work this out. I've got some credits to claim.
What is the Empire offering? We can match it. Alderaan has wealth. We can...
You can submit to Imperial rule, or find every man, woman, and child wearing that collar.
Sir...
This spineless toad will make a poor lord of Alderaan.
Yes. It will take work to shape him. I hope you will undertake this for me. I would like to offer you a commission. Be my representative in House Thul. Aid Jorad and his men in crushing all resistance to the Empire. Obey him as if it were me, and with the same penalty for defiance. Tell him what you need, and he will ensure Thul's hold on Alderaan.
Yes, sir. Sir.
Penalty for defiance? I like the sound of that.
I suppose the Moff expects us to take on House Organa. They're one of our oldest noble houses, and loyal to the Republic. Until recently, they've been without an army, but they've got supporters all over the planet. Including here.
You'll never find them. They've got top-of-the-line cloaking, better than anything the Empire makes. No probes will get through, no spy sats, nothing.
You got the brains of a bantha.
House Organa denied raising an army, claiming it's just patriots defending their lands. But their attacks are too organized. We'll never find every group. We need to get inside their planet-wide communications. And that means finding a base with a physical link to slice into.
Whatever. I'm on the clock.
How can you destroy the culture of an entire world and call it a mere day of work?
Silence! If you stand with the Organas, you betray 1,000 years of loyalty.
The Organa guerrillas have a base hidden in some cave or other natural camouflage. There should be a master comm link there, guarded by their best soldiers. If you insert this computer spike, it'll give us a backdoor into all their communications.
Once we can hear them, there's nowhere on this world they'll be safe.
House Organa will not make another move without us knowing.
Impressive work. You can see we now have access to the Organa systems. They're all talking about the ruthlessness and brutality of the recent attack. They do train you Imperials well, don't they?
I'm no Imperial, but I'll take that as a compliment.
I thought you might. Now that we can monitor the Organa's communications, it should be possible to...
Lord Thule, the base is under attack.
Send aid quickly. Border Outpost 2 under attack. I repeat, under attack.
Perimeter defense is breached. We're under attack by assault droids. Repeat, a coordinated attack by probe and assault droids.
Blood of the Queen.
I'm no soldier, but I could probably defend your base.
Yes. Go now. Hazard pay. Whatever you want. The data says all three border posts are under attack. Looks like a coordinated effort. Hunter killers and probes. All I've got out there is a skeleton crew. You're the only one close enough to reach them in time. Please, save my bases and bring me the memory cores from any probes you destroy. I want to know who's behind this. Good luck.
I'll bring you the heads of those droids and their master.
Thank you. Now hurry!
Sidekick, Buster.
I cannot thank you enough for your quick work. I don't know what the Organas were after, but that attack was long in the planning.
I'm always a professional.
Moff Sarek was wise to hire you. No one else on Alderaan acts with your swift brutality. Who's the source of these? What were they looking for? And quickly!
The programming signatures point to Lord Cedric Kilesa.
Lord Kilesa's my vassal. He swore loyalty to me personally when we returned from exile.
Bottom line, no one's gonna serve you if it doesn't serve them.
The parameters indicate the probes were to join an assault team in a... My lord, this program indicates an assault team massing in a tunnel between here and the Kilesa Estates. I don't find any such tunnel on the blueprint.
The siege tunnel! Blood of a queen! They're coming through the siege tunnel!
Those attacks were meant to draw your guards away from the palace.
The wretched traitor! That tunnel connects his lands directly to our estates. No one's used it in centuries, but the tunnel opens right under this room. What are we going to do?
defeating a standing army goes for time and a half.
Yes, of course, whatever. This is my family's home. Moff Sarek gave us cartons of thermite explosives. They take time to set up, but they pack a punch. If you take them into the siege tunnel, you can collapse it on Cedric and his army. Seal the access so they can't threaten us again.
You should have sealed it off the minute you went to war.
You have taught me the importance of taking action.
There's an entrance to the tunnel nearby. The storeroom is in the same area. I'll recall my troops to defend the surface, but there's no doubt the real battle will be below. Thank you.
So, you're the Imperial puppet who taught Jorad Thule to bite instead of bark. Does he lick your hand? Fetch your slippers? Real Alderaanians will never bow to the likes of you.
Yield, and you may keep your title and your lands.
I would sooner see Alderaan blasted into space debris than given over to the Empire. You don't even have the guts to fight this yourself, instead of hiding behind a cart and a thermite. If you had a shred of decency, you'd settle this by an honorable duel. You against me.
You against me.
You surprise me, Bounty Hunter. I thought your kind couldn't change their minds unless they're paid to. A duel of skill, then. If you win, I will give my house over to Jorad Thule to use as he will. If I win, you stand aside and let me cleanse Alderaan of this scourge and tell your Imperial handlers Alderaan lives free or dies! To arms!
It's the Priest sidekick, Buster.
I concede. You have the better skill. Perhaps it is Alderaan's fate to fall to the Empire. I will tell my people. We must find a way to live through these times.
Show them that sometimes there's more strength in yielding.
I will tell my army to stand down. Thank you for this mercy.
Kalesa's just surrendered. My men are returning from the outpost to take them into custody. The Kalesas are acknowledging you as a man of honor. I will tell Moff Sarek of your heroism immediately.
I have won your place for you fairly, in a way they understand.
An unnecessary luxury, but it did not cost us the battle. This time. The Thals need not fear any further rebellion in their ranks. If the Empire is to keep you on retainer, our money would better go toward using you elsewhere. General Stunnel Thull is coordinating our efforts near House Ald. Speak to him if you'd like to take a further role in this conquest.
You have saved my house's dream of ruling our world, and taught me much about what that will mean. I will not forget.
Stunnel Thull, I was told you want to see me.
Yes, Moff Sarek said you'd be here. We've had an inspection team lost to the Killiks for days now, advisors from Droman Kaas. They were inspecting one of our mining sites for lanthanide deposits. But in the middle of their inspection, the entire place was overrun by Killiks. We've had no communication for days.
I want the full briefing. Risk assessment, strategic importance, all of it.
Moff Sarek wants the inspection team rescued, and fast. Apparently some of them hold serious rank off-world. And the Killiks don't exactly respond to negotiations. They're the native aliens here. Giant bugs with just enough sentience to shoot a blaster. Attacking these Killiks would take half our army, but apparently I'm too close to the problem to strategically assess its value.
You have some kind of personal stake in this?
Yes. I don't want you to think I'm asking for personal reasons, but my daughter was leading the inspection team. I don't know if she's alive or dead. If you can find her, find our advisors, free them if they're prisoners. I promise you a reward that will leave me bankrupt.
You start digging into that treasury, I'll get everyone out of that mine that walks on two legs.
If you rescue Daria, I will gladly give you my every last credit.
have removed those who are not of the nest. Had they stayed, they would have learned the peace of the joining. We will not deny you your prize. But leave now. There has been a song of swarming. We have claimed these mines for the nest.
What are you supposed to be?
Once we were called Daria Thul. Now we are known as New Child of the Ukanuku Nest. We have tasted the gel and scented the egg chamber. We have joined.
So you're a Killik now?
There is peace in the nest. A love that comes of sharing one mind. It is a gift beyond measure. We will never return.
How can you live like this?
How do you live in a world where everyone is a stranger? Where a smile may conceal a knife in the back? Stanothul is not my family. He and his kind have brought war to Alderaan in the name of their own power. Here we are safe. Here we are at peace. Here we will stay.
Come with me, or die along with every Killik here. That's your only option.
No, we will never. We are hearing the voice of the nest. We have decided it is not worth many losses to save one. The nest has spoken. We will return.
Thank you. My medics are treating the inspection team for shock, but they seem otherwise unharmed. I wish I could say the same for my daughter. It is clear those monsters have drugged her, brainwashed her. I've heard of this, something in the pheromones that joins their captives to their hive mind.
Turn Thule's troops against the Killiks before they can destroy another mind.
You're right. What good is the throne of Alderaan if our world is first overrun by these bugs? They must be driven out! We should slaughter them until nothing but their mounds remain!
General Thule, excuse me. It is urgent I speak with my rescuer at once. I'm Agent Craig Graf, Imperial Intelligence. It was no accident those Killiks attacked when they did. The Ulgos pushed them toward that mine.
You make a habit of getting captured on your missions?
Of course not. But the Killiks share a mind. Once one sees you, there's no escape. We didn't even have time to activate a comlink, report what we'd learned. The push was orchestrated by the Ulgos to distract us from something they're calling Operation Sunshower.
You Alderaanians are entirely too cheerful.
I've heard that term. It's come up a few times in the chatter we're getting from our back door into the Organa networks.
It's a Baradium detonator, a massive explosive. They plan to strike at the heart of Thullands. The detonator's being transported by Boris Ulgo's elite soldiers, former Republic Special Forces, with the best weapons they could take and all the training the Republic gave them.
My trigger finger needs some exercise.
Just before the Killiks arrived, we acquired a data file that I believe to be the launch codes for the detonator.
If you really wish to strike fear into the heart of the Ulgos, get into the camp where they're holding it and set it off prematurely. It won't be the full force of the weapon, but let it be Ulgo that perishes, not Thule. Thank you. You are again Thule's savior, saving our lands from devastation and death.
I had wondered why an outsider was entrusted with so many secrets of the Empire. Now I see there is no one else whose abilities compare.
Do those words translate into credits?
I can certainly offer you a bonus for your service, Bounty Hunter.
With the Ulgos retreating, I can turn all my troops to rooting out the Kilix, to the last squirming larva.
My superiors have been asking about you. There is some intrigue happening with House Wrist. Trouble for our allies. If you're interested, look for Dathis Elgin. Moff Sarek has already commended you to him.
Ah, Hunter. Dathis Elgin, Imperial Advisor to House Thule. Am I glad to see you? House Thule faces a crisis that threatens to undermine their entire position on Alderaan. And the Empire's as well.
I need money up front.
If you save Thule, I'm sure they'll gladly provide a reward. House Wrist, Alderaan's House of Assassins, is currently aligned with the usurper House Ulgo. But there was a time when Wrist did all manner of secret jobs for whomever paid. Now the dirty details of those jobs are threatening to get out.
Wake me when you're done.
A former Wrist assassin, kicked out for revealing the identity of one of his employers, is blackmailing Thule. He says he'll reveal every assassination, every kidnapping, every conniving thing Thule has done unless we pay him.
What made you pick me to talk to?
We've arranged a meeting to deliver payment. But he's recruited some of Wrist's best assassins to his side. I don't trust him. That's why I need you. Someone strong enough to withstand whatever trap he intends to spring.
It's a done deal.
This man wants to establish his own House of Assassins. And he has demanded land and a title as payment for his silence. Take this case and meet him at the assigned meeting place. If he takes the bribe, fine. If not, kill him.
Well, brother, would you look at this. A bounty hunter. Well, what do you know? Thule isn't half as stupid as I thought. It won't do them any good, but I give them points for trying. Now, if you'd kindly hand over the payment.
I'm not giving you a thing until I'm sure there's no tricks.
Tricks? We've only just met. You already know me so well. I thought Thule would send some scrawny diplomat I could take hostage, but you'll fetch a higher price.
I'm going to enjoy kicking your face in.
Don't get your hopes up. We've been doing this our whole lives.
This guy! He has the better of us, and besides, it's not worth it! The evidence is already on its way to House Ulgo. He had no intention of giving it to you.
You will all pay for this.
Sam, you idiot! We could have been counts!
You've lost all sense of honor. Lying, stealing? I swore to live by a code! The runner with the evidence is delivering it to Ulgo's son, Vessix.
Sam, you'd betray your own brother? I'll kill you for that!
Damn it, Kai. I'm sorry. Look, the coordinates the runner was headed to are in the console over there. You might be able to catch him if you hurry. I'll take Kai's assassins. I promise, neither you nor Thule will hear from us again.
No one betrays me and lives.
Tell me you've defeated Vessix. Tell me you managed to destroy the evidence of Thule's misdeeds before Ulgo was able to distribute it.
You've got my guarantee.
Never in my entire life have I been so relieved. Here is a reward from House Thule. You've done a great thing for the Empire. I hope you realize that.
Hold up, Bounty Hunter. I have orders from my superior, Darth Victus, to place you into contact with him immediately. Don't go anywhere.
Ah, Lieutenant Muir finally caught up with you. I imagine it comes as no surprise that your activities have not escaped the Empire's notice. I am Darth Victus. Today you have the opportunity to perform a great service to the Empire. This service will reap plentiful rewards. Do you accept this opportunity?
Somebody's gotta reap those plentiful rewards. Might as well be me.
The task at hand involves House Pantia, the weakened former rulers of Alderaan. Though most believe them wiped out, a few stragglers yet survive. These surviving Pantias are needed to legitimize House Thule's eventual rule. We are creating an understanding with them even now, but the forces of House Ulgo plan to interfere.
Why are the Ulgos so concerned about House Thule?
Buris Ulgo, House Ulgo's leader, was a Republic war criminal before he usurped Alderaan's throne. His hatred of the Empire is well known. Ulgo has strike teams massing Thranta for transport. They intend to assault the Pantheer's Mountain hideaway and slaughter all surviving members of the House. The eradication of House Pantheer would greatly impede our plans for House Thule's ascendance. It cannot be allowed. You will find the Ulgo strike teams and destroy them at once.
I'll keep it in mind, really.
It would be best if you kept the interests of the Empire foremost in your priorities. Report back to Lieutenant Muir when you have done as you should.
Good luck. Welcome back. Probes have confirmed the full elimination of Ulgo's strike teams. I will contact Darth Victus immediately. My lord, Lieutenant Muir, the matter is dealt with.
Perfect. The Empire is fortunate to have such a capable servant. This accomplishment will be well rewarded.
Is this job finished?
So long as enemies remain to be crushed, the Empire's work is never done. I'm currently engaged in negotiations with the Pantheon survivors at their mountain hideaway. I will arrange for you to be allowed inside. Be sure to conduct yourself cautiously. The Pantheon hideaway is neutral soil. They won't tolerate uncalled for aggression. One obstacle still stands before our plans for House Thule. Buris Ulgo, the supposed king of Alderaan himself. We'll speak more when you arrive.
Farewell.
Good, you've arrived. Allow me to introduce you to Lord Auron Pantheer, nephew of the late Queen Silara Pantheer, rightful Queen of Alderaan. Your lordship, this is the hero I spoke to you about. The one who prevented Ulgo's barbarous attack against your noble house.
It is an honor to meet you. My family owes you a great debt. You will always be welcome in the home of Pantheer.
Making problems go away is what I do best.
The elimination of House Ulgo's strike teams has forced them to draw men from their castle guard. The heart of their house lies exposed. Given your exemplary service in defense of House Pantheer, Lord Auron has deigned to grant you an opportunity to shape the future of Alderaan.
Boris Ulgo, head of House Ulgo, has betrayed the noble laws of Alderaan and stolen the throne for himself. It will be your task to remove it from him.
Sounds like a suicide mission.
If the goal was simple, we would not need help performing it. Darth Victus assured me that you are capable. Please, do everything within your power to capture Boris Ulgo alive. The people of Alderaan deserve to see that usurper face justice. They deserve...
Begging your pardon, my lord. An urgent matter requires your attention.
Very well. Tell me what's happened.
Captured alive, you will do no such thing. Even in chains, Buris Ulgo is a threat to House Thule's ascendance. He must be killed at all costs.
Isn't it our goal to make Pantheer happy?
We will be eliminating House Pantheer's greatest enemy. That is their only true concern.
My apologies. Now, you understand the gravity of the task being given to you, don't you? Boris Ulgo is at the center of a castle stolen from our house, surrounded by an army of loyal troops. Until now, no one has dared challenge his position.
I always get my target. Period.
We waited so long. This will be a momentous day. I must make preparations. I'll arrange for a special detachment of our elite Queen's Guard to move in behind you and collect the usurper once the job is done. Good luck.
Do not fail us.
And here we are. It's just as I predicted. A mere tool of the Sith Empire, just like the beasts in House Thule, sent to wrench the throne of Alderaan away from those who rightfully possess it.
Go ahead and waste time babbling, pal. I get paid by the hour.
Fool, don't you have any idea what you're trying to do here? What those monsters have put you up to? I was the only one strong enough to do what was necessary. The people of this world deserve a leader who will defend them. I will not surrender this throne for you or for anyone else. Only I can keep it safe. Only I can protect Alderaan.
You're mighty proud of yourself, aren't you?
I believe I've tolerated your intrusion long enough. Destroy this assassin, men! Defend your king! Defend Alderaan!
Not just the pretty sidekick, Buster.
Not over. I'm not dead yet. I won't let you win. I won't let the Empire's shadow fall over Alderaan.
Your fellow nobles can decide your fate.
So be it. Let the battlefield change. I will fight to protect Alderaan from the Empire's filth to my last breath, just as I always have.
Area secure, everyone. Looks like the hard part's been taken care of. Boris Ulgo in the flesh. Wasn't sure if I'd ever have the pleasure.
Save your mockery, Pantyr. If your house were stronger, we wouldn't be here now.
Prisoners, do not speak.
Let's get this traitor out of here. Lord Orin, the operation was a success. Boris Ulgo is in our custody.
It's finally over. The usurper will finally face justice. You were right, Lord Victus. Our house owes you and House Thule a great debt.
Yes, I must admit, even I am surprised that it was possible to capture the usurper alive. I hadn't expected that particular windfall.
I think I'd do a little something extra.
Of course. No reward is great enough for what you've achieved today, but you deserve everything we can give. You have delivered Boris Ulgo as promised. You have proved House Thule's commitment to the good of Alderaan. So you will have my support.
Will your influence be enough to persuade those misled brothers and cousins of yours who have sided with House Organa?
I'll do my best, but the Organos may not take well to losing. I fear this conflict could be far from over.
After all that I've done, House Thule's position still isn't secure.
It is only a matter of time. You should be satisfied that you had the opportunity to play such a large role. Your work is done for the time being. You can go on about your own business.
House Pantyr will never forget what you've done for us. Thank you.